is one of the things we may want to discuss, because you got to be at the airport by 5. Okay, be at the airport by 5, so we consolidate everybody, then we do the checking in and so on. Okay? Okay, transport. The transport we require at least a little bit detail here. 26, when we drop at Bali, when you get down to Bali, I don't need everybody to move. We'll stay in the airport. We'll talk about the detail packing later on. But you will just take your hiking pack with you, be at the airport. The rest of the stuff that you do not need will go to the hotel. But I don't need everybody to go to the hotel. A few of us will consolidate all the bags, get a transport, we'll go to the Quest Hotel, drop all our luggage down there, there'll be a safe keep there, then we'll come back to the airport. Clear so far? So when you pack later on, we'll tell you how to pack it. You pack your hiking gear separately, then your other stuff separately. When you go there, you must be able to take out your hiking gear. The rest, you give it to the admin group. We'll settle it at the airport. Because we do not want you to bring to Lumpur, leave it down there, climb, come back. Just leave it at the airport. When you come back the next time, your things are there already. Okay? From Lumpur to Rinjani Resort, we will be... Once we touch down at the airport in Lumpur, we will go. The guide will bring us to a place, they call it a resort. I do not know how it looks like, but that's where we will stay for the night. Then early morning, we will embark with our hiking plans. Okay, there's a resort just for you to rest for the night only. 27 early morning from the resort, the transport will take us to the registration station. This is where I leave Gopi and Ambi to do the registration for all of us. There is a requirement just like Kinabalu, register your particulars and all that. I don't know whether your passes and all that, they probably still have that. And then from there, we will bring us to the start point. At the same time, on the 28th, this support group here, there's another arrangement for the support group where the hotel will go and fetch you from the airport in Denpasar and bring you back to your hotel. And then from there, you will kick off your own program until we meet you on the 29th. 29, our end point is different at the track office. We will be brought back to the airport, and this is where I say instead of the bus or the mini combo van or whatever, they may change it into a car to make it faster for us to reach the airport. Then we'll come back. We'll come to Bali. From Bali, there will be also a transport. That evening, we plan to have you can call it a celebration dinner. Okay, when we finish all the hard work, we'll come together. We have a good dinner in Bali. And then after the rest of the night is one time on target. And 30th, we will ask for consensus. We think we can. We still have a transport. I think Selim has got a contact of a transport that is given to Ambi. We probably will go to this place called Tana Lot if majority feels okay. I'll show you a bit of that. And then that day is pretty easy. And the last day on the first transport is arranged for us from hotel to the airport. Okay, these are all the arrangements done. So, like I said, transportation will come back to you on whether or not we need to top up or we can do it within the funds. Okay. Next. Accommodation on the 26th. On the 26th, the small resort is there for us. Of course, on the 27th, early morning, there's a light breakfast catered for us before we shoot off to the registration office. 27 to 29, you'll be staying in the Quest Hotel at the field. It's like this, we have a condition, don't expect, not like KK where we have a proper place to stay, the hut and all that. This one is field camp type. If you see the pictures here, the kind of food you eat, all is like that. This one is only when we come back to from Bali, that's Quest Hotel. Okay? Twin sharing has been arranged. I confirm this is supposed to be breakfast only and not boyfriend only. Somebody asked me why twin sharing boyfriend. It is breakfast, Okay, but Quest Hotel, I was told, is only about 10 minutes from the airport. So it's quite convenient. Anything on this? Okay.
How about toiletries?
The campsite. Field one, you want to answer that?
I think we need to bring the toiletries, like tissue paper. But I think they'll be like, the army style, where you got the dig and all, I think they'll be doing that kind of thing. They'll have a separate place for us to go toilet and all.
They will have an auger to dig hole. That one is a field bombing. We'll do field bombing. But you bring your own toiletries. I would suggest in the list we given, I said bring toilet paper also. Okay. It's field condition. Those who have been to the SAF Army field camp, imagine that way. What I think is provided for is all the food, but sleeping bags also, right? Sleeping bags and all that are provided. Otherwise, your own personal item you have to bring. Apart from the eating stuff, eating items, which they have basic meals, and sleeping items, which is sleeping bag. Okay, now I changed the orientation. Just now I said, you turn it upside down. This the north is below. We will start this place called Sembalun, Lawang. And then we will go down to the south. Day one, you can see that. Okay, day one is on the left. We start at Sembalun, or we end up in the crater rim. Correct? Day two, you will hit summit, and you will go to the lake. Day two. And you come back to the, they call it the second rim, crater rim. And day three is where we need to rush down all the way to come down to the end point. Just an overview. What is day one, what is day two, and what is day three? Okay? Of course, there are some people who do the other way around. There are pros and cons to doing this. Gopi arranged to the guy to take the, and he suggested this way. You see, when you are fresh on the first day, the chances of you hitting the summit probably is higher. If you do the other way around, you will only reach the summit on the second day. By which time, hey, come back. Yeah. Our treasure is here. Okay, Satu Song. Okay, before we start, Ronin, quick description of yourself.
Sorry?
Quick description of yourself.
Half t-shirt. You are old people.
No, just your name.
Intro. Better than sticks as well.
Yeah. What's your name?
Hey. Ronnie. Just call me Ronnie lah. Ronnie will do.
Age school?
Age 42.
Where are you working? Are you working or
what's the one? Working, yes. I mean, get to know me along the way lah. It's okay.
Don't
worry. Hey, Gucci, wait. I'm okay. Wait lah, wait.
I'm trying to warm you up, then you just...
No, I'm really warmed up.
Okay. Back to this. So, like I said, if I take the other approach, you only reach the summit on second day. And then we know some of the second day can be too tired and you... The challenge is always the summit because many of you may have heard by now that it's a volcanic region. A lot of ashes. There are some pictures that will show you your legs can go in as high as your boots. That kind of condition. You take two steps or three steps, you slide back one step and all that. So it can be very tiring if you do it on the second day. So they suggested this way, and I think it's a wise move. Still strong on first day, we make it to the summit. The rest of it is to enjoy the lake, and then last one is to come back. Okay, next. Okay. This is where you need to look at programs. We have to manage the time carefully. I need everybody else to cooperate. The time here is just a rough timing. If you think you need more time to go toilet and bomb and clean yourself, please wake up earlier. Otherwise, if you're the quick and fast one, then this timing, I think they are such. I think the way they look at it, we are all very cowboy style, very fast one. Go there, wake up morning, quick brush. You don't know whether shit or don't shit, but you get ready, go for breakfast. So, first day morning, 6 o'clock, wake up. They will give us the hint. You can wake up on your own. If you need to wake up earlier, set your own alarm. 6:30, breakfast. See, half an hour for some people not enough, some people may be enough. 6:30, breakfast. By 6:45, latest, I don't think we have to move from there. Because the journey from the resort to the registration point is about an hour. About an hour. Then at 8 o'clock, Gopi and Ampi will sort out the registration. We get all the things sorted out. Then 8:30, we go to start point, we start the track. As per what I said earlier, my objective, at 8:30 we start on the 27. So 8:30 we start. So 8:30 we start. First one is 2 hours walk. Okay. Whether or not we have been training like that in Singapore, put that aside. Here, I need to tell you that we have to continue walking for 2 hours. So if you think you are tired, buddy buddy, or you can reach your own water bottle along the way, open, drink, put it and carry on walking. Don't go there and say, can I stop for a while, I need to take a break. No. I think if we do that, if I start to accommodate everybody, we will be very, very slow. Try to understand this this part of the challenge. Otherwise, some of them are all 1 hour, 1 hour. Of course, we can stop if we really, really need to. But if you can, be with us, walk, follow this timing, do your own hydration plan, we reach a point. So first one is 2 hours. So plus minus. So 10:30, they call it post, in Malay it's post, post one. Okay, per month one, post one. That's by the time you already got about 1,300 meter height. Then you will stop for 10 minutes. Quick 10 minutes, drink up. You need to take your muesli bar and all that, you carry on. You manage your own plan. After that, you will walk for another hour to post two. Post two, 1 hour. Tengjan Guan, something like that. 1,005. They are only more interested in height altitude, not so much about the physical distance. And they talk about time and height. 1,005. After 1 hour, another 10 minutes of break. Then we go to post three, another 1 hour. So altogether, 4 hours already. Okay? After 4 hours, 1,800 meters of height achieved, we will stop there for lunch. Okay, they have given us a very comfortable 2 hours kind of lunch. I don't know whether we need to use that, but we will size up the situation accordingly. To me, 2 hours may be a bit too long, because once you stop too long, you want to start our engine all already cold, we have to warm up again. So we will see how it goes. If we have enough time, because in 2 hours, I think they cater for time to also cook, because it's all fresh ration, they will cook. I don't know what they cook, gado gado, nasi lemak, all I don't know. I heard from Ambi, she said like that, but if you're not very comfortable with all the sambal stuff, then you eat your own ration. But I think you need some warm food. Okay? So if you can leave early, we leave early. But whatever the case can be, because Ambi's perception is some of the guys may not be walking with us, they will go much earlier, they go there and start preparing already, because they know, they experience. But let it be, if we can start earlier, we start, but latest by 3 p.m. By 3 p.m. we have to move out from lunch point. Why so? Because we need to reach the first crater, the Semulan crater rim. We need to reach there before it gets too dark. Otherwise it becomes more challenging to walk in the dark. Okay, but that place is not like Kinabalu, all steps, all tracks, and I think visibility may be a challenge for us. We reach there by 6 p.m. because we will camp for the night. So we want to reach there before last night. So my, the one in green are all critical times to me. 3 p.m. move, 3 hours walk. Okay, 3 hours, I said 3 hours, so no stop one. We have to move because we have to race against the light. We are going to be there by 6 p.m. But once you are there, we are good and safe. But then you can take your time. I think people like, our situation not here, like to take photograph one. This is a good place to take. They say the sunset and the sunrise view is good. You can see the lake from there, you can see the village. Half of North Lombok can be seen from there, it seems. Later when you go to the summit. Okay? Who else? I know besides Balan. Who else? All those photography freak on every time one must take everything yourself. I know when we say take photograph not only here, along the way, we shall want to request later on. Whoever can take photographs, you just take. Okay, but not taking photograph until I stand there 10 minutes and give me, just along the way, quick snap. Later on, we consolidate all the pictures as one, we open in series and then we share each other. Anybody got video? Balan is not coming. Video. Okay, if you can take video, that'd be also good, if you can have videos. Okay, this is day one program. All I need you to know is just look at the one in green. That are the key things. We start from the village. We need to go up to the crater endpoint. Objective for day one. Okay? Next. Just to recap. Day one, start from the village and end up at the crater rim. Day one. After midnight. After midnight. Okay. When I say day one, until dinner time. Yeah, we will reach the summit after midnight later. So this bare we need to achieve for first day, yeah?